Hey guys, welcome to another episode in the deep playthrough of Gran Turismo 4. Let me double check the microphone. Anywho, we did a pretty tough race in the previous episode, which actually turned out to be 3 hours long. With this Renault 5 Maxi Turbo on Tahiti Maze reverse against another Renault 5 Maxi Turbo. Eventually, I managed to do it, but goddammit, it was hard. Hopefully, we have, I think, 4 races to do or 4 tracks to complete. It's mostly is normal direction and reverse direction, so 2 races per track in the special condition events. And the special condition events are mostly rally courses. I think by head, next one on the agenda is the only one that is not really a rally course. It's a Tsukuba circuit. That's also the only one that does not have a reverse layout. We will be doing that. We are in the hard category. You have to do them all the races and the special condition events. All the tracks, you have to do them once in easy mode, once in normal mode, and once in hard mode. So in that sense, it's a bit repetitive, but it does provide very cool rally cars as rewards. And it also forces me a bit to buy some cool cars to mix it up. I'm not going through it all in let's say one Subaru Impreza rally car. No, I'm really trying to mix it up, as we will be doing now. The only thing is that we are in the hard event, so most of the competitor cars are quite fast. And there are this one, I think I tried in the previous episode and didn't really like it that much, so we'll leave this one now. It also looks more like it's actually a Group B car, but it's way underpowered compared to the others. Like this Maxi Turbo at 350, the Nissan 240 RS only 240. It almost looks more like a rally race car, like an endurance rally car. And this one, for example, has like 100 horsepower more than the Renault 5, who has more than 100 more than the Nissan. So this Peugeot 205 has like almost 100% more horsepower than the Nissan. Anyways, I was thinking with going with this car, because that's a reward car. Pretty damn cool. The only thing is it's not 4-wheel drive. I do think it's mid-rear, so it's rear-wheel drive. And it, again, only has like 277 horsepower, which for Group B standards really is quite low. But let's see if we are competitive. Maybe the competition will also not be that fast, although I think that is an idle hope. And it also will be Tsukuba in the wet, so with a rear wheel drive car. Yeah, an Audi R8 race car. Not really going to happen, I'm afraid. What a weird competitor. Normally it are all rally cars. I'm not even aware that the R8 was in this game, a race car. Let's see, this game came out in 2004. Let's see what the when the R8 came out. One moment, we do a new tab. Audi R8. This is what I mean. 2006 to present. How can it be in a 2004 racing game? I don't understand. Maybe based on a concept car or something. Or did I read it incorrectly? Did it say Audi R8 or something else? Yeah, it did say Audi R8. Right, I have no idea. Let's see how quick it is. Ah, it's a Le Mans racer. pretty good chance we will be biting the dust. Here we go. Maybe the AI is super slow, I don't know, in the rain. It's just crazy. Not going to work. I will use that Stratos for another race. Yeah, so we have the R8 as a possible opponent. Let's see if there are what the other opponents are so that I can choose a car that is not too overpowered but also not totally underpowered. Yeah, these are all Le Mans prototype racers, so I guess we need a similar car. Find it really weird that the special condition, it really was, except for Tsukuba, it are all rally courses or rally races. Find these Le Mans cars, it's fun, but it doesn't really fit in with the rest, so to say. Anyways, I do think I have a Le Mans racer somewhere here. Although, I don't really quickly see any. Here, we have one over here. R89, we raced several Le Mans races in that one, I think. We also have a Pagani Zonda race car. We could use that for just to mix it up. I don't think I really use that one a lot yet. We also have this Toyota 7 race car, also pretty damn cool. Probably the brakes will be super bad. Let's use that one for something else. Let's for now go with the Zonda. Was just curious how much it's worth. It could very well be... What's the drivetrain here? Mid-rear as well. It could very well be that we are still underpowered. So annoying. I've mentioned it also in the previous episodes. This cursor sometimes goes super quickly and then you overshoot what you want to press. I've so many incorrect button selections during this playthrough just because the cursor or that D-pad stick, whatever it is, it's super inconsistent. Alright, at least we have the same model year as the Audi R8. Ah, I already drove this one because the driving aids are already disabled. I don't even remember driving this one. This is actually quite tricky still. Holy shit, this is tricky. I don't want to have another like 5-hour race. To be honest, I really want to get these special condition events over with. I want to do something else. We've been in these special condition events for so long now. I really like the rally ones, but I just don't feel like again spending 3 hours trying to win it. Normally I don't like changing cars. I just want to work with what the dice throw at me and just get better, like in the previous episodes. But I cannot do that each and every race, and this car really was constantly spinning, super annoying. So I think I am just going to go with something that has four-wheel drive. I think I'm going with this one. I mean, in the rain, that much power, you cannot put it down anyways. You need traction, I would say. All right, the only thing is, I'm not sure whether, I'm not sure whether I'm still on dirt tires. I was, but the game auto equips the tarmac tires. All right, let's see. Ah, now we have a different opponent. Whatever. I mean, what do you mean understeer? God damn it. Oh my god, this car understeers. Nope. God damn it, what the hell? This is really annoying, to be honest. Alright, screw it. Then I'm just going to go with that. That's the problem. I can go with that R92 Nissan Le Mans racer, but even on a dry track, I drove it without traction control, and I prefer to drive it without traction control. I don't even think that car had traction control. Although I'm not 100% sure about that. But if I cannot even put the power down, it's 922 horsepower on a dry track on Le Mans, how in the holy hell will I be competitive on a wet track? So yeah, I have no clue what to do, to be honest. Except just trying stuff. Let's just try this one. Man, I was not expecting this to be such a tricky race. Problem is the understeer is just crazy. I can't just take that Nissan R92 and put traction control on. But yeah, traction control, really not my thing. Yeah, I was afraid of this. I forgot, this car has terrible brakes. Nope. Oh my god, again, wrong button selection. It's, oh my god, it's such, it looks like a minor thing, but if it happens like 200 times, it gets all so, sorry to curse, but so fucking frustrating. Fucking hell. All right, I have no clue what to do, to be honest, and my mood is getting sour over here. I just wanted to make some progress after a 3-hour episode, previous one. Probably there's no other, there's no such thing as an easy lunch. I just have to put in the effort, probably. So. Alright, it's not the 92, we have an R89. Let's see if that one had traction control in real life. R89C traction control. I do think I already tried to look that up earlier and I couldn't find anything. The Google results are incredibly bad now compared to some years ago. So again, indeed, no relevant results. If you Google R89C traction control, you only get crap results. Google, it's just a crappy company. Everything goes downwards last 10 years. Everything. Gaming, music, movies, fintech companies like Google, everything goes down the drain. Everybody collectively losing their mind. Sorry, but just annoys me. Anyways, I can take this car, but I don't want to put on the traction control, to be quite honest. I do think that traction control was a thing in 89, but I'm not sure whether it was actually implemented in these group, what is that, group 4 racers or prototype class, I have no idea. And if it wasn't, I don't want to activate it in my game to artificially win the race. And the problem is, I could look it up, but it will take me half an hour of searching the correct trustworthy forum somewhere in the corner of the internet to know whether this car had traction control. Apparently this is an easier race in this car. Here, this is what I mean. With no traction. This is hardly doable. Once it gets going really good, but are you kidding me? I really cannot put the power down. At least let's practice a bit. Fuck me, man. This is annoying. I really cannot get the power down. But again, the key thing is, just like in many of these special condition events, I just need to... get quickly in first place and then just block the competitor. So I have a chance of winning. Oops. Sorry. I'm literally... I wanted to say I was literally... spinning. I was literally spinning. Until, I don't know, fourth or fifth gear. Fuck me, man. It's super annoying race, but at least I have a car that in theory I could win. I mean, I was briefly in first place, so I'm happy with that. It's just quite an annoying race because you really have to modulate that throttle like crazy. Probably I have to just lose second altogether, second gear. I will just try to see. He bumped me as well. Alright, now it's just a matter of keeping the door closed. And I mean, the inside of the corners. Shit. Right, before last lap. So far, things looking good. Alright, going way too slow through here now. Right, to be honest, let's skip the replay. Normally I watch the replay just as a mini reward, like a job done, and also just to get the race out of my system. But this, somehow, I didn't find it that much of an enjoyable race. And let's indeed try and make a little bit more progress. So let's get the hell out of here. Hope we get like a cool reward car. Sorry for the ranting and raving, because I just had like a deja vu to yesterday with all the frustrations for GT02. Pretty cool. It's not like the race car, but it's still a pretty damn cool car. Very nice color combination. Alright, done. And now let's get back to rallying and let's see if the Stratos is competitive. Holy shit, we only need to do two more. I thought we need to do four or something more. Man, I could actually finish it today, if all goes well. Yeah, there's still four races, of course. But let's try anyways. Where is that Stratos? I don't think it will be competitive against probably much more modern rally cars. But you never know. It would be nice to mix it up car-wise. Fuck me! Right, if there will be a car that is way quicker, then I will try and restart the race a couple of times to see if they're here. This is what I mean, this Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution, that's like a super quick car. I can try what I want, but I will never win that in this car. Probably the other competitor car, it's also just like Subaru Impreza or something. It will probably be one of those two. So. Okay, a little bit older Impreza Lancer. 99 model. Ah, Delta Integral 92. Ah, actually, in a previous episode, I think I said that the Delta Integral was like a Group B car. That's of course not a Group B car. Or at least. I don't think it. 92 is like. '92 is like 6 years after Group B was abolished. I will just drive a bit. This is the first time I'm driving this car. See if we can at least, I think we had like a 5 seconds gap. See if we can reduce that a bit. really reducing it. Nope. All right, to be honest, guys, I've had it. I want to finish this whole everything. I'm just going to get a better car and just win the races and be done with it. I would like to do just some tarmac races. I've been at these rally events now. I've done each course like 3 times, except these Cathedral Rocks. Which we're doing the 3rd time now, but still, at one point. It makes sense to move on to something else. So yeah, call it a bit cheap. Normally it's really not my modus operandi to just get a quicker car, but screw it. Oh my god, why is it also tiresome? I thought I already had dirt tires for this car. Ah, I bought snow tires for this car. But to be honest, I find these in Prezzas, they are of course the most modern rally cars in the game. They don't feel particularly quick, to be quite honest. Alright, and I do have to remember the course a bit. Ah. We are driving against another Impreza, just like previous episodes. Renault 5 Turbo against Renault 5 Turbo. I do like that because, I mean, it is fair, of course. Why do I get the penalty, peoples? Can you tell me that? Holy shit, I was too busy closing the inside corner where they normally... where they normally take over, overtake. But this goes actually... I'm really happy with this. I mean, it's quite... a fair race, but it's actually not that hard. Way too much braking. Oh shit! Ah, I thought that was way too late on the brakes there, but not really. I do have to say that all that rally driving, it did teach me a bit how to drive a bit better in these cars. And it's actually quite enjoyable. Sliding around, oh shit. Oh shit, I missed the apex. Man, this car is actually super fun to drive. I was a bit underwhelmed with it at the start, because when first driving it, I bought it when I was super frustrated with the Ice Arena Challenge reverse. It was crazy difficult, so I've only really driven it on ice. But it really feels a bit like real rally driving, like a rally driving game. Like WRC on the... even better, because you really feel the sliding around. It's really quite well done. And the Scandinavian flicks, etc. Alright, we need 3 more races. Can we do that this episode? I would say yes. I will just keep this car. Shit. Screwing it up over here. Alright, final lap. Nobody can say it was because of the car. We're driving the exact same car. Too much braking over there. And over here again as well. Alright, good enough for me. A little bit messy, but screw it. We have to be a little bit quicker because we're already over the 45 minute mark. So let's quickly do these three races. So we have one race now in reverse over here, and then two races which are like this same track, but then without the asphalt section. That's the second variant of Cathedral Rocks. The Trail 2, apparently it's called. Alright, again some integral. Normally I would like to balance out the performance of the cars, but again, don't care. Just want to get a bit of progress. Ah, it's actually keeping up. Was not expecting that. How is it so quick, suddenly? At least I didn't get a penalty there. Ah, fuck me, man. Fuck me. Why is that car so crazy quick? 10-year older car. Ah, we are actually also quicker. See you later, dudes. Holy shit. Man, he's not making any jokes, that integral. Alright, I braked way too much over there. Oh shit. And over here I braked way too little. Over here, the integral, I hear him again behind me. It's really quicker than you would think. And I'm overshooting my corner here. A bit messy. But yeah, no time to lose. Still have two more races to go. Alright, so over here I can keep more speed, but alright, second lap. And he's gaining on me. I had like four something seconds. I slightly hear him behind me. Alright, here we go, no more kidding around. Either somehow, I don't know what it is, but it feels like this reverse layout feels like a longer course than the other direction, which of course doesn't make any sense because it's the exact same course. Still, I think I can carry much more speed through here, but would be nice if we can put him on like 10 seconds gap. Should be possible, but now again, I'm just too slow through that section. He's gaining. I had like 8 seconds, and then I had 6 seconds. We still have 1.5. Left to go. There we go. More than 10 second gap. Alright, car got a little bit unsettled there. And now the gap is probably sub 10 again. Ah. We're still above 10. Alright, final round. Still losing a second there again. Somehow that start finish section doing something wrong there. But man, I really have to say, the whole rally mechanics, I remembered it to be that I really wasn't enjoying it that much, but I must say, it's much better than I remember, thought it would be. That whole sliding a car around feel is very well implemented. And the sound of this car actually, here, this is what I mean. If you take too much speed through there, it's really easy to bump into things. But anyways, the sound of this car, also not too bad. Alright, great. Let's quickly, we will watch the replay of the final race, but let's quickly make some progress and do the final two races. Ah, we're actually getting a reward car, I think, which is always nice. Suzuki Escudo Dirt Trial Car. This is apparently an extremely fast car. It's for Pikes Peak, but really overpowered, I think, if you use that one on the rally stages in this game. It could be fun nevertheless. And here we go, final special condition event. Same track as before, but then minus the tarmac section. So in theory, or not in theory, absolutely, it should go quicker. But yeah, we still have 10 laps to go. In total, 2x5. We have some fair competition. Oh, fuck me. You know what, I will just continue. I totally stepped on the power too late. But maybe... holy shit. Maybe we can keep up. Although I always screw up that one. And this one. Way too much sliding around. Go. Oh, all kinds of invisible walls over there. Woohoo! I do have to say, that's one funny jump over there. Yeah, anything, that invisible wall over there. Woohoo! Oops, almost lost it over there. Not sure what I'm doing here. Man, I'm always hitting the walls here. It's quite a bit annoying. We'll try to do at least one lap without hitting the walls over there. Not sure what lap this is. Fourth one, I guess. If so, then we have one chance left to do that last section clean. Alright, didn't hit any walls. I did go through it quite a lot slower, I think, than normally. But seriously, these tracks, they're so fun compared to what you have in GT7, which are all these boring, wide open racetracks. Here you have like narrow sections. It's just more fun. Hard to put your finger on, but and there we go. And now final race of the special condition events. Almost brings a tear to my eye. Man, there were some really frustrating ones here, but it was overall much more enjoyable than I thought at the start when I saw all those repetitive races. And yes, I'm cheesing it a little bit. I'm not against this Lancer, actually, because I wanted to have a faster car. No, the Lancer is the same model year, the same type of car. So I'm actually not cheesing it. But luckily, these races are just not that hard compared to others like Ice Arena or Grand Canyon or Tahiti Reverse. They were also, that's the weird thing, all those races were pretty doable. In the normal direction, but all in the reverse, they were just crazy. Alright, second lap. play, totally screwing up that section. But yeah, we're still in the lead, so good enough for me. Oh. Again, I'm hitting that wall. It's super annoying. Previous race with the tarmac, the trail one. I didn't hit that wall ever. Now suddenly I have a problem with it. Or it's not really a wall, but the fence, so to say. Right, we are now totally screwed up that corner. I lost a lot of time there. Ah, no. We're still around the 9 second mark. Fourth lap. You see, lost like 2 seconds because I'm just driving bad. Would be nice if I can still get it to a 10 second gap, but I doubt that will work out. Ah, fuck me, man. Alright. Can forget about my 10 second gap aspirations. Anyways, before last lap, this of the special condition events. Right, 9 seconds. All goes well. I could maybe still get that 10 second gap. Yes, nice. 11 second gap, although I totally screwed up that corner. All right, very nice. And that was it. That was all she wrote. Let's watch one lap of replay. And then I unfortunately have to end the episodes because it's just a Monday working day. But very nice that in one episode we managed to do 3 events. First one was quite tricky with the wet conditions on Tsukuba, and then afterwards it went a lot easier in this Subaru Impreza on Cathedral Rocks. And actually quite enjoyable, just a little bit of relaxing rally driving. A lot of slowdown with the Vulcan renderer. DirectX doesn't have it, slowdown, but I do think that the Vulcan renderer may give a little bit better car reflections. And I'm just like a graphical fanboy, so sometimes I prefer a bit of slowdown over worse graphics. And such a cool car, this is my favorite Subaru, the Globe Pine. Now I'm playing Gran Turismo again. I've actually looked at this car in real life. Maybe I will have to look at it a bit more. At one point when I hopefully, when Bitcoin does its thing finally. Right. That was that. Cool song, by the way. Maybe we also get a reward card for just completing the total events. I don't know if that is a thing, but would be pretty cool. What was the previous reward card? It was the Escudo. Alright, what do we get now? Pajero Evolution Rally Raid. Yeah, not really my thing. It's for endurance rally, but that's not a thing in this game, so I'm not sure why these cars are in the game. I mean, it is nice for the variation, but yeah, there's not really like an endurance rally track, like a Nürburgring for rally or something. Right, do we get anything else? No, goddammit. But yeah, I cannot complain, because the amount of cars that we got was pretty damn epic. And that completes the special condition events, all gold. So what are we going to do in the next episode? I have no clue. We are only 31% underway. I guess the extreme events, because the, and then there are also one brand races. We could also start mopping up all those. Because to be honest, the extreme events, they look pretty fun, but they also look very, very long. Maybe they're not that long, but I did see some of them have like, I don't know. No, it's not that long. Then that were the endurance events where I really saw like 50 laps or something. This is all pretty doable. Just checking out the amount of laps. Alright, this is only 5 laps. That's a very short one. But this one could be much longer. Formula GT. Here, this is what I mean. 60 laps. Are you kidding me? 127 laps, 74 laps, and then 10 races. That's just crazy. And then World Circuit Tour. Alright, this is again doable. Alright, so it's mainly this Formula GT, which is crazy long. But yeah, probably I will just, in the next episode, we will just start here. And it are championship races, I think. So you really have to pay attention right from the start. And also, yeah, I don't think I need, pitting is not really a thing when you have like 9 laps, maybe there you would need a tire change, depending on the cars. This one seems pretty doable, to be honest. But for the Formula GT, you really have to, I need to do some research, like how long are hard tires usable, how many laps, and the medium tires, etc., to be able to come up with like a viable strategy before I start that whole championship. Because these are all championship. Once you lose a race mid-championship, you cannot just stop. You have to continue. It are not standalone races, it's a series. Just like these two. Anyways, we will be tackling the extreme events in the next episode. After that, I will be doing or mopping up all the single mark races. Like you have probably for Lancia. Not for Lancia, but maybe for Alfa Romeo. Yes, one make races. Probably fun little bite-sized challenges. So we will be doing those. And then we are making quite some progress already. Then we have the Japanese events, we have the Euro events, and we have the American events also still to do. We could also do those. Fuck me, those are also all kinds of championships. But these actually look super fun. Right, maybe I will do the Japanese and the Euro events and the American events. Yes, let's do that, because I don't feel like doing these 10 race championships immediately. I want something a little bit more bite-sized. So we will be continuing with the Japanese events in the next episode. Guys, hope you enjoyed this one. Hope to see you there. For the meantime, don't forget, always do keep on gaming. Later.